Hello, I'm Gavin Hoey and you're watching another Photoshop tutorial. This week we're going all three-dimensional because I'm going to make a three-dimensional cube inside of Photoshop. After we've made the cube, I'm then going to wrap some images around it to make a three-dimensional photograph. Let's see how it's done. So I've already got a picture open on screen. Really this is just an A4 image, but it's going to make a nice background for my picture. So what I need to do now is to make a new empty layer. There we go. And on that layer, I'm going to make a selection with the rectangular marquee tool. But I'm not going to make a rectangle, I'm going to make a perfect square. Now, to make a perfect square, simply hold the shift key as you make your rectangle. So something like that, and you'll get a perfectly square selection. Now, with the gradient tool and the color set to white and black, I'm just going to drag a little gradient just across here, something like that. Okay, so I fill that selection with colour. And that's going to make one side of our cube. So having made one side, we've got to copy this twice more to make the other two sides. So keyboard shortcut, Control and J, and then Control and J. And that'll copy the layer like that. Right, let's shut those new layers down. We don't need them. And let's just work on this one layer for now. Because although I wanted a perfect square, I'm now going to make it a rectangle. Yeah, I know. There's a crazy logic in here somewhere. Just stick with it. So let's come up to Edit, choose Transform, and then we're going to go for Free Transform. In fact, let's just stick with Free Transform. And we're going to shrink our square down a little bit by grabbing one of the bottom handles here and bringing the height up until it's 90% of its original size. So how do I know that it's going to be 90% exactly, or as close as I can? Well, look at the options bar along the top and you'll see the numbers next to the letter H change. And I'm looking to try and get it exactly on 90%, but never quite get it on 90. So 98.8, that's perfect. Now, before I click the tick, I've actually got a couple of other things to do as well. I've got to make my width 70%. Now, this time you'll watch the W and you'll see that change. And 70.2, can I get it spot on? No. Never mind, 70.2 will do. Again, don't click the tick yet, one more to go. Right-click inside, choose Skew, and this time I'm going to drag this middle handle on the right-hand side up. But this time it won't change the shape, but the angles. I'm looking to change the V angle to 25 degrees. So something like, if I can get there, 23, 24.7, 25. Look at that, spot on for once. Okay, we'll click the tick. Right, okay, so that's now made our little side of our 3D cube. But I need a couple more of these. I don't really want to go through all this work every single time, so here's a neat trick. Turn on the next layer and make it active. Go back to Edit, choose Transform, and then select the word again. And that'll apply the same transformation as we did before, you see. Go back to Edit, choose Transform, and flip horizontal to spin it around. So now you can put these two sides next to each other and they should snap in like that. Okay, so that's two of our three sides done. Third side's not quite as simple, just got to do a little bit of work to get that right. So let's activate that layer, turn it on, and we've got to turn this over a bit. So we're going to go back to Edit, Free Transform, and spin it over, but hold the shift as you twist it because we want it exactly 45 degrees, so just there. Now let's put this where it should be, and it should go almost perfectly on those corners of our cube. This is going to be the lid of our cube, as you can tell. Here's another neat little trick. Hold the Alt key, Mac users hold the Option key, and drag up the bottom handle here, and as I'm holding the Alt key, the top handle will mirror it like that. So I can twist this shape until it fits perfectly onto the lid of my box. Something like that. Okay, we'll click the tick. Right, so that's all three sides done, but it's well worth just having a little close-up look, because although we've been reasonably careful with our numbers, we're never going to be absolutely accurate, so a bit of fine-tuning is normal. Have a look up here on the top of the lid, and you can probably see it just overhangs a wee bit. So I'm going to go back and use a bit of Free Transform and just shrink that in like that. And then I'll just check the other side whilst we're here as well. The other side's spot on, so we'll click the tick. Lovely. The last thing I'm going to do is change the lighting, because I've got the lighting sort of right on these two sides, but the lid, it doesn't quite work. So using the Control key, that's Command on a Mac, I'm going to click that lid layer so I get a selection. And then I'm going to get my gradient tool again and drag another gradient, but this time from the bottom towards the top. So I add white at the beginning. That's not quite enough white there. Let's put a bit more in. Something like that. Yeah, that's better. Okay, great. And we can lose the selection, select and deselect. And that gives a better looking three-dimensional gradient. Right, so we're kind of done with this bit. Now, what would be a really good idea at this point is to save this picture. Because if you're ever going to make another cube, you really don't want to go through all that hassle again. So it's a good idea to save this as a template so you can use it again in the future. Right, I'm going to collapse these three layers down. So select them all, layer, and then merge layers. So that's now merged down into one layer. And I'm ready to start adding a picture onto this now flattened cube. So I need some pictures, really, don't I? Let's see what we've got here. Let's open the first one, which is a bluebells. In fact, all of my pictures are bluebells because I like to add the same sorts of pictures to these cubes. Let's make a square selection. Now, if you've got a good memory, you'll know that we hold the shift key and drag a rectangle to make a perfect square, something like that. And then we'll go to edit and choose copy. Okay, close that down. Don't need to change it. Back to edit and paste. And it'll bring it in. Now, by chance, it's almost the right size, but it doesn't always work out that way. But let's see if we can get it roughly in the right place. Well, nearly, but of course, we've got to do a bit of bending to get this image to fit onto the side of the cube. Now, we've already done the hard bit. We've made the cube template. So this time, it's going to be much easier. Up to Edit, choose Transform, and then choose Distort. And all we need to do is just distort these corner handles and drag them onto the corners of the cube we've already made. So that'll go on there somewhere. That'll go over here somewhere. That'll go down there. And that'll go roughly over here. Okay. Something like that. When you're happy, click the tick. There we are. We now have one face of our cube done. Right, let's open up another one. Let's open another picture to go on. Next one along. And again, we'll make a perfectly square selection, holding the shift key, dragging a square out. I'm going to use the keyboard shortcuts, Control-C to copy, Control-V to paste. Bring up the distort. Lovely. And we'll distort this one onto the other side. Like that. And like that. And side number three, or corner number three. And then corner number four. There we go, lovely. It's worth spending a bit of time trying to get this absolutely right. And that's as good as I'm going to get for now, so we'll click the tick. And we need one more for the lid. Let's bring that picture on. And again, we'll make a perfect square selection, holding the shift key, then Control and C to copy, Control and V to paste. And we'll find that distort once again. And we'll just distort these corners onto the corners, and this is going to be the lid. That's one side, that's two sides, that's three sides, and that's four sides. It's worth having a good look at your picture before you hit the tick, just to make sure you've got it absolutely right. And I think for now that's absolutely as close as I'm going to get, so that's fine. So our 3D cube is looking, well, quite three-dimensional. That's not too bad at all. But remember, we put those gradients in right at the beginning when we were making the squares. Now, those gradients weren't just there so we could see the edges of the cube. They're there to give you a three-dimensional feel if you want to. And we can achieve that by changing the blend modes. So at the moment, the blend mode is set to normal. But if I change it to overlay, it'll pick up that color gradation from the 3D cube. Let's change the others as well. So we'll change that to overlay as well. And the last one, the same, to overlay. Lovely. So that's looking pretty good. Last thing I'm going to do is to try and make this look like it's floating above the background. So let's first of all raise it up in the air a little bit. Let's just grab all of those layers and shuffle it up in the air a wee bitty, like that. And then we'll make an empty layer at the bottom. Get ourselves the paintbrush tool with a black as our colour. And we'll just paint a shadow along the base here. So something like that. And just drop the opacity of that way down, so we give it the look of a shadow, just to make it look like that cube is just floating in the air like so. Okay, so there we are. There's how you can make a three-dimensional cube, wrap some photographs around it, and create an image that just looks a little bit different.